This is a little bit of an insight into the world of jade, I think. The real jade, the raw jade. And I think that it's really important to maybe share principles of how I live. I think Jay Shetty once said, what you're like on your own when no one is watching is the true authentic you. So I want to share a little bit about my life. I'm going to save that for another time, although if you're in my emails, you will have seen a little bit of my backstory, aside from athlete jade, etc. And you will have known that I went through a huge health transformation approximately 9 years ago, after suffering ME and actually self-teaching, essentially, with some help and input from friends who are in the holistic and natural medicine world. So it's become a massive value of mine, food, and essentially what is going in your body, trying to maintain a internal healthy terrain, because I want to stay as disease-free as possible. You know, it's not all about performance for me. It's not all about, well, it is about performance, of course, but not just athletic performance. It's my daily performance that's important to me, my longevity and what I'm doing, and obviously sharing all of my principles to remain as healthy as possible. Enough of that, please. They don't want to hear you as well. So I just want to take you through a little bit. Now, I've just done a food shop on a Sunday, ready for the week ahead, which is one big priority of mine. Otherwise, I'm, you know, leaving myself picking things and getting snacky and stuff like that. So one big thing I really value, and one of my biggest focus points, is obviously clean food. So if it's not kind of like one ingredient, I try and remove it. Okay, so I'm trying to stay away from things like artificial colors, flavorings, preservatives, additives, all of the stuff that makes and creates internal chaos, basically. In the long term, will create fatigue, it will create mind fog, inability to sleep, autoimmune responses, so lots of arthritis, etc., etc. Like arthritis, when we're thinking of autoimmune diseases, we're not just thinking about like the big stuff, we're talking about, you know, inflammation. Okay, so the biggest thing is removing inflammatory foods from our diet, which is going to allow us to have more of an alkaline system, right? So we want the pH to sit nicely in our body so that we don't have an environment where things, disease, can start to basically create itself. So let's go through then a little bit of, I'm going to do this as like a two-part thing. So I'm just going to literally keep this one really casual, show you a little bit about what's in my food basket from week to week. Around us, we really, really struggle with our meat. I do get asked a lot, like, am I vegan? Am I vegetarian? Absolutely not. It's my body doesn't run well that way. And I've always been a meat eater, but I am a true believer from time to time in moving through a gut cleanse. Okay, so around 4 times per year, I will actually go through a full gut revival program, where actually for that 21 days, you do take out, you know, a lot of additives, a lot of preservatives, a lot of nightshades, a lot of things that can basically inflame your gut lining. So gluten, and then eventually you do actually take out meat, because sometimes red meat can be harder to digest. So it's basically just giving your body a little bit of recovery or a kickstart, and everything starts in your gut, like when it comes to health. So I do that 4 times a year. I can maybe one day share with you guys exactly what that looks like when I go through it. But for now, we're gonna keep it to my sort of like week to week, you know, stuff I order or I get week to week. So obviously let's start with meat then. So at the moment, I listen to my body, like what my body's asking for, what it's craving at that moment. Like, your body is the teller. So it, you know, you need to feed it what it's asking for. For me at the moment, like the last couple of weeks, I've been really leaning towards red meat. Organic is obviously a no-brainer for me. I don't like to have estrogen. I don't like to have antibiotics secondhand, which is what, you know, nowadays, due to mass production, you know, sadly the meat isn't what it used to be back then. Fish, obviously, another thing as well is it's very, very difficult to find line caught fish. Okay, so actual wild Alaskan salmon is very, very difficult to find. I was lucky enough that Waitrose had it right now, and someone's getting a little bit excited over the smell of that, but it's not for you. So this is essentially my meat for the week. Okay, so this will be like a homemade chili, the beef mincemeat. This will probably be some level of like just really basic steak, sweet potato, raw butter, etc. Could be made into a stir fry. Sometimes I'll even have steak and eggs for breakfast. So aside from the meat, obviously I want to just work through a couple of bits and pieces that I have from week to week that are an absolute essential. Obviously micronutrients, everything sprouted, okay? So I actually lean more towards sprouted veg than I do actual vegetables. I save that for another day, but that's really, really important to me. Coconut milk and raw milk is a massive one. We have a delivery of this from a farm in Bungay. I will not touch unpasteurized dairy or unhomogenized dairy. So homogenization and pasteurization is what actually creates intolerances. So raw milk is a goer. Every single day I have at least a pint of raw milk, have it as a shake with clean protein. Obviously healthy fats are in here. I've got the cashew nuts. Bells is gonna make a homemade fruit and nut mix. So you've got cashew nuts. Coconut sugar is the only sugar that I will touch. So anything like refined sugar, anything like that, I try and stay clear of. Things like organic maple syrup, raw honey, okay? So local, as local as possible. Coconut sugar as well if you want to sweeten anything up. Also got the fermented foods on the go. So these are all gut loving as well. So fermented sauerkraut, homemade radishes that are fermented as well. So you can just literally let them soak in the fridge. With some apple cider vinegar, and then for anyone that's wondering, like clean treats and stuff like that, my on bar is a massive go-to of mine. Again, it's as close to the cocoa as possible, it's close to the cocoa bean as possible, and again, it doesn't have any refined sugars in there. Obviously a lot of fruit, eggs, again, no brainer. Dragon fruit is one of my favorite. I will talk about these quickly. This is coconut miso. So instead of soy sauce, I'm not a fan of soy. Again, it can be damaging to the gut lining, can be really quite an inflammatory response in the body to too much soy. So coconut miso is a really, really good go-to for things like stir fries, etc. Oats summer, I get a lot of questions about oats, okay? So I have to be very careful because oats are essentially a stodgy carbohydrate, as I would call it. However, when you're doing a lot of training and a lot of running, as close to organic as possible, or gluten-free as well. And you wanna look on the back of things. With things like granola and muesli and etc., what you can find is there's a lot of oils, rancid oils, like sunflower oil, rapeseed oil, all of those things packed up, compound over time are gonna cause a lot of gut issues, okay? So when you're looking at things like this, that's the stuff that you guys want to steer clear of or make your own at home with coconut oil, all right? So, as I said, I'm vlogging today. My whole day of food. So this is going to be interesting. I know a lot of you guys have reached out. Quite a few people when I talk about my nutrition are quite fascinated. So yeah, let's go with it. So just trained this morning, did a heavy lower body session day, lots of sled pulling, lots of strength work. So this is pretty much, I've jumped in the shower. This could have been done a little bit sooner, I guess, but we're not perfect. So I'm about 25 minutes post-training. So this is raw, unhomogenized milk, unpasteurized as well. Pasteurized and homogenized dairy that you get in the supermarket is the one that kills your gut and creates a lot of inflammation. So you want to be aiming for a raw if you are going to have dairy. There's a banana in there to get the glycogen levels back up. There's going to be a tiny little pinch of sea salt to bring my salt levels back up. You go 2 scoops of protein. So this shake alone is probably going to give me around 40 grams of protein. At 52 kilos in body weight, I'm quite small, obviously. I probably aim for around 130 to 140 grams of protein a day. So this is getting 40 grams of protein in already. This is grass-fed collagen. Again, I seek out the best quality that I can possibly find. Like, that's a biggie for me. So it's super important. This is the Osso grass-fed collagen, by the way. I would never have collagen that's not grass-fed. Same as my meat. Me and Bella obviously sometimes have a little bit of a row in the morning because Keiko sets her off sneezing. She has some weird allergy to life. So sometimes she'll have it with just this, but for today's purposes, I like to make this into a banana and Keiko.
And can smoothie. We just excuse the NutriBullet?
This is Mum's, by the way. I liked to soak the whole of my NutriBullet after it had raw milk in it in the sink, and then it blew up. So this is Mum's magic bullet. She is single, if anyone's out there watching, in the 50 to 55 category in Hyrox. And yeah, so Keiko. So a lot of people that have low levels of magnesium, Keiko, and it's got to be organic Keiko, raw Keiko. Some people say cacao, however you want to pronounce it. This is going to give you really high levels of magnesium. If you struggle to sleep as well, it can normally be down to low levels of magnesium. So there we go. Like I said, this is an absolute game changer. This is going to be breakfast number one, by the way. Breakfast number two incoming. So gotta whiz this up. Hopefully mum doesn't ask this back, because this will be a really good one for traveling when I go to hotels. It's tiny. We do like the look. This one's going to the vets this morning, aren't we? She's hurt her back leg. Could be a possible ACL tear. So lots of love this morning.
She likes raw milk too.
She likes raw milk, don't you, mothers? Hmm? But not Kate though. So that's my breakfast number one. Breakfast two, I will document. We might go to work from, I've got some athlete check-ins to do this morning after we drop this one off at the vets. So I might get some eggs, etc. at the place we're going to do a bit of work from. Can I have kisses?
Where's mummy?
Can I have kisses? Kiss? Okay, kiss. Okay. Ooh. Ooh. Speak. Ooh. Well, sometimes she does and now I just look like a weirdo. All right, so yeah, over and out.
Plus one equals two, and it's me and you.
There you go.
That's all we'll have when the world is.
Love you, babe.
Oh my god, she's like Ronnie. Oh.
I just want simple things, to smile with me, babe.
Maggie will always.
I
like
this.
What are you doing?
Love
you, babe.
Cause I just want simple things.
On the way to the vets with Mr. Fishy in front, with Mr. got this suit in slowly. Jay Fishy.
Three options here.
The
fisherman.
Fisherman.
Fish chip shop owner.
Or
just Mr. Fishy with his fishy family.
There's a whole fishy family in that van.
Some more protein, but remember eggs are not a whole protein. A little bit of bacon, wouldn't usually go for bacon, super, super processed. Lots of nitrate in bacon, which isn't the greatest, but we move. I'll probably have a little bit of porridge when I get home, which will be my small carbohydrate portion. But for now, we're good. Breakfast too. So, obviously documented this morning's brekkie. This is going to be a big meal of the day. I don't tend to eat too much after like 5, 6pm. Obviously my training session number two today. So I've trained this morning. It was a general performance prep session and strength session. That's about an hour and 15 minutes. This afternoon at some point is going to be a steady run, 70, 80 minutes. Eggs are shouting. That's cooking in raw butter, by the way. So again, unhomogenized, unpasteurized. Bells has her steak pretty much blue. So I'm gonna cut it in half, because I'm gonna cook mine first. I've already prepped the bottom of the Buddha bowl I'm gonna have. So on there is some mango, raw spinach, sprouting broccoli and sprouting rabbit radish. What it comes like. The most nutrients ever. Like this compared to just broccoli is like another level, completely different league in terms of nutrients, anti-cancer, incredible on every cellular level for your body as well.
Show me what's in your jars.
In the jars is fresh salad. So that's obviously prepped on a Sunday to make sure it's easy to just grab. So that will go on the plate. I'll show you like finished product soon. This is homemade
radishes
in apple cider vinegar. This is kimchi. Again, fermented foods are incredible for the gut. Some beetroot in there, which is great for nitrate oxide, and then obviously some boiled eggs as well for extra protein. But we're not gonna have them because I'm already frying up an egg. So that, now, usually I would have rice with this as well, but I'm gonna save rice till my run, after I've done my run, because otherwise my stomach will be quite stodgy. I tend to run well on medium carb intake, but I run really well on protein and fats, so that's my go-to. I know how I feel, it's not for everybody, but everyone works completely differently. So yeah, I'm cooking up a storm. Gonna get some raw butter in here, just sliced up some raw garlic as well, which is gonna go in, and yeah, we're ready to rock. Obviously, organic steak is a necessity for me, like grass-fed, super, super important. I don't want any antibiotics in my meat. I don't wanna be having that secondhand. Have you ever had such a cute nose? What do you want? Do you want some steak trimmings? Would you like some fat off the steak?
Yes, Mom, give it to me.
There you go then.
Oh, was that nice? Was it?
The finished product, voila, took all of around maximum, I'd say 12 minutes to prepare, if that, 10 minutes. So there's an egg about to go on top, but just wanted to show you the masterpiece. Get in my belly! So this is a post-training snack. So this is mixed berries frozen with pineapple. And I'm currently slicing some dates to put on top. Gonna pop a tiny bit of granola in there. If you wanted to make this more like protein based, you could definitely put a bit of protein powder in with the actual smoothie mix, but you can use like any frozen fruit and a tiny bit of coconut milk, but you're better in the Nutribullet, but you're better to use less coconut milk and have it really thick and keep adding to it rather than making it too runny, because then it just turns into a smoothie basically. So this is some granola. This granola is the best one I've found. I don't really like walnuts, so. Is the best granola I've found in terms of base mix. So this is from a local farmer's market. The lady does it, bakes it at home. So it's gluten-free oats, and it doesn't have a sunflower oil base. So it's not cooked in sunflower oil, which is good. Obviously staying away from rancid oils. That can really affect the gut lining and stuff like that. So this is made with coconut oil, this one, so being sure of that. You can top it with loads of different stuff. I like to top it with, this is my favourite, granola. I'm going to put a little bit of almond butter on there as well, and also a tiny, tiny drizzle of honey. This is like my post-workout go-to, just to get nutrients, antioxidants back in, get carbs back in, and get sort of, you know, usable nutrient dense sugars back in as well. So dates are low GI, berries are low GI, so they're not going to spike my sugar levels massively. So yeah, that is the afternoon snack. I just told Belle to shove the camera back on because I've just found some kiwi, which is going to go down a treat. Not really sure how we cut kiwi. Don't think I was ever
like
taught
that.
Okay, well, this is how it's going.
The kiwi.
All right, well, this is how it's going down at the moment. Then I'm gonna go into blocks. Doesn't matter what it looks like, tastes good. This isn't the best Buddha bowl I've ever made, by the way, in terms of aesthetics. Not Buddha bowl, acai bowl. You can make this with acai berries, obviously. That's why they're called acai bowls, but I don't have them.
Just got a little less of.
Sorry. Not sure how to skin a kiwi. You can actually eat the skin. Apparently it's quite good for your intestinal tract because it's hairy.
This is painful.
So we're just gonna have to stay here watching this for another second. Maybe pan round to the dosed up little mare over there.
Thanks.
This poor little lady has been to the vets today for a scan on her MRI. So she's a bit out of it, aren't you, baby? We picked her up and she's a little delusional. So
She's eating lots though. We need to get lots of water to flush all that anaesthetic out. Hey. The conclusion is that she has an ACL rupture, which, as we know as athletes, isn't the best, is it?
Operation.
Poor baby. Operation. Okay. So, I've got to look after you. Lots of DLC. Good girl.
This is the reality. What are you eating?
Nuts.
I mean, it's really not that interesting, but still, I could hear you snacking from the other room.
What do you mean?
This is what I hear about midday. Is this searching? And these are really good. If you have a five-year-old, okay.
What's in the brown bag?
A date, everyone, a date to get started.
This is about as exciting as it gets.
They're mine.
Being a clean living athlete.
You won't even eat those. No. Dates and butter.
Dates and butter will take like this. Will taste like this.
In Waitrose this week for a little treat, and she has the audacity to say to me, Bella, why don't you just eat dates and butter? Because I need something in my life. A little naughty. What do you think?